Chapter 4 of Darwin's On the Origin of Species is a crucial chapter outlining his views on natural selection, but it's also 51 pages long. In this video, I will give a breakdown of the 8 different sections of this chapter and say a few words about what you should focus on in reading each section. The chapter begins with 8 pages comparing natural selection to artificial selection. This is pages 80 through 87 of the first edition. In the first paragraph, Darwin defines natural selection as the preservation of favorable variations and the rejection of injurious variations. Key points of this section include that natural selection is capable of even more powerful and more profound transformation than artificial selection by selective breeding, that natural selection is capable of producing an immense diversity of organisms and the survival of only the best adapted ones, that natural selection adaptations are gradual, almost too gradual to be observed, and that natural selection can only select traits that increase the survivability of the individual possessing them. Altruistic or self-sacrificial traits are going to be a problem for this theory. The second section is 3 pages of comments on what Darwin calls sexual selection. The editor, James Costa, notes that here Darwin recognizes that reproduction is the ultimate evolutionary currency. Main points include that within each species, males compete against other males to mate and reproduce, and females compete against other females. Both of these selection processes work to improve and transform the species from generation to generation. The third section is 5.5 pages of illustrations of natural selection in action. Darwin describes at length some observed cases that show his theory and how it works. These cases include hunting wolves and the pollination of flowers by bees. The fourth section is 6 pages long, dealing with intercrossing or outbreeding. It was known in Darwin's time that repeated inbreeding caused weak and sickly offspring, and that occasionally crossing varieties with more distant varieties led to increased health and vigor. Darwin gives several examples illustrating and supporting this conclusion. The fifth section is 7.5 pages on circumstances favorable to natural selection, which Darwin calls an extremely intricate subject. He discusses the effects of various factors on natural selection. These include a large number of heritable variations, intercrossing, physical isolation, and largeness of area in which the species dwells. The sixth section is a 2-page treatment of extinction. Darwin considers the factors and mechanisms of species extinction. This is a short section, and it's worth a careful read-through. The seventh and longest section is 16 pages and includes the only illustration in the book, which is a chart. It deals with divergence of character, the way competition between similar species eventually produces separate, distinct species. Major points include the mechanism of divergence, with examples from nature and from artificial selection, and the benefits of divergence and species diversification, again with many examples. Darwin then explores the way that divergence of character combines with natural selection and extinction, and this is where he uses his chart. The remainder of this section, from pages 116 to 126, along with the included chart to which it frequently refers, is worth your careful attention. The final section is 3.5 pages long, and it's a summary of the entire chapter. The summary provides a good overview of Darwin's argument so far, and I urge you to read it carefully, both before and after you read the entire chapter. I hope you found this breakdown of the sections of Chapter 4 helpful. Thanks for watching today. Goodbye.